Hi Sudan, welcome to Botany Online class. Today we are going to learn about 12th standard biobotany, unit number 9, plant ecology, in chapter number 7, ecosystem. Chapter number 7, ecosystem. Now we are going to learn about biogeochemical cycle. Biogeochemical cycle are nutrient cycle. So first of all, what is meaning of biogeochemical? Bio means living organism. Geo means rock, air, and water. That means a biogeochemical cycle. So the exchanges of nutrient between the organism and the environment. So what is meaning the nutrient? What is meaning the nutrient? The substance that are provided nourishment of the essential for maintain of the life. That's why nutrient. So this is the essential for the ecosystem. Why this is essential aspect of ecosystems? Because all organisms, they are required nutrition for vital process. Already we learn about this word vital process. For example, this growth. So that are for both plant and animals, their increases in the size day by day or year by year, their increase in the size that are required the nutrient. And then reproduction. So it is one kinds of the important process. They are found in the lot of cell divisions. They are required in the nutrient. Another one, development. For example, in plants, developed in the leaf, the formations of the flower and etc. They require in the nutrient. And then maintenance of the body, both plant and the animals. So again, why this the essential aspect of nutrition or aspect of ecosystem? Because all organisms, they are required nutrition for growth, reproduction, development and the maintenance of the body and etc. So therefore the circulations of the nutrients within the ecosystem or biosphere, that is called biogeochemical cycle or cycling of material. Cycling of material, again, the circulations of substance or nutrients within the ecosystem or biosis, that is called biogeochemical cycle or nutrition cycle or cycling of materials. And then there are two basic type of biogeochemicals. They are gaseous cycle Another one is sedimentary cycle. So the gas is actually these are part of the atmosphere, and then sedimentary cell that are found in the soil. So first one, gaseous cycle. So the gaseous cycle including in atmosphere, carbon, oxygen, and nitrogen cycle that are included for gaseous cycle, and then sedimentary cycle. The sedimentary cycle that are found in phosphorus. Phosphorus, sulfur, and calcium cycle. So these are found are present in the soil. So already in previous classes, already in my class level, the read for gaseous cycle like carbon, oxygen, nitrogen. Phosphorus cycle, sulfur and calcium cycles. Therefore, in these chapters only carbon and phosphorus cycles are explained. So first one is carbon cycle. So what is in the carbon cycle? The circulations of the carbon between the organism and their environment are the circulations of carbon component or carbon substance between the organism and environment are organism and ecosystem or ecology. That's why carbon cycle. So this cycle is important. The carbon substances are indubitable for all part of the biomolecules. All parts of biomolecules. So biomolecules, already we learned that previous classes are lower class level, nucleic acid, DNA, RNA, carbohydrate, protein, fat, lipids, all the substance. So the all the substance that contain the carbon component. So therefore this substance is unavoidable for all the biomolecules, and the substantially the important for the changes of climate are global. Changes of global climate. So the increases of carbon dioxide level, there increases in the temperatures. So the changes in the climate, and then this cycle, the cycling of carbon between the organism and the environment having the concurrences of two reciprocal processes. A reciprocal process. They are photosynthesis. Another one is respiration. So already we learned that the lower class level photosynthesis during that time they are fixed with carbon dioxide and evolved in the oxygen. And then this process a drop of oxygen and evolved in the carbon dioxide. So the reciprocal process photosynthesis they released the oxygen, that oxygen utilized for the respiration. The respiration evolved in the carbon dioxide, thus carbon dioxide utilized for the photosynthesis. That's why a reciprocal process. And then what are the process they are released in the carbon, there increases in the atmosphere. There are the four or five substances. The substances are released in the carbon. Finally, there increases in the level of atmospheric. So, for example, the atmospheric increases of carbon dioxide due to burning of fossil fuel. First one process, and second one is deforestation. Third one is forest fire. Then fourth one is vulcanized eruption. Then fifth one is decomposition. Decomposes of the matters. So again, the burning of fossil fuel. There are 90% of the carbons are they are evolved with the burning of the fossil fuel. For example, petroleum, gold, oil, and gas. So that are released in the carbon. Another one, deforestation. A huge amount of forestry cut are removed. So thus the process cannot fixed in the carbon dioxide during the cannot takes place in the photosynthesis process. So that are the increases in the carbon level. And forest fire under the next. Volcanic eruption, decomposition of organic matter. Already we learned that previous classes about decomposition of the matters or decomposition. The breakdown of detrite substance into the simple organic matters, that's why the decomposition process. So all the process they released in the carbon. So finally there increases in the atmospheric level. So next we are going to discuss the phosphorus cycle. So it is one kind of sedimentary cycle. Already we learned that sedimentary. So basically, or actually, these are found in the earth or water regions. That means a sedimentary cycle. So already we learned, already we know that the phosphorus found in biomolecules. The biomolecules like DNA, RNA, ATP, NADP, and phospholipids. So these are found in the bio or phosphate molecules. So first one is either DNA and RNA, that are kinds of nucleic acid. They are found in the nucleic of cells. And DNA, ATP and the NADP, so that are found in the cell organelles like mitochondria and chloroplast. Chloroplast. Phospholipids, so that are found in plasma membrane or biological membrane. So basically that are outermost layer of the animals, but the secondary layers of the plants, that means the plasma membrane are biomembranes or biological membranes. Thus membranes made up of phospholipids. So what is meaning the DNA, RNA, ATP, NADP, external phospholipids? DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, ribonucleic acid, adenosine triphosphate, nicotinamide, adenine, triphosphate. All are you see the phosphate place in the phosphate group. For example, this the DNAs are found in nucleotide and nucleoside. So the nucleotide contain a phosphate group. Nitrogenous base, already you learned that the structure of DNA and the structure of RNA. And then sir, adenosine triphosphate. See sir, found in the phosphate. Adenine, nicotinamide, adenine, triphosphate. So all the biomolecules having the phosphate molecules. And then all the living things at the cellular level are the living organism. Then thus phosphorus molecules are phosphorus not abundant in the atmosphere. Okay, where is this found? So this is found, the bulk quantity of phosphorus present in rock sediment, sorry, rock deposit. A bulk amount of phosphorus present in rock deposit, marine sediment, and these parts having a bulk amount of phosphorus. Okay, how this substance they are released in phosphorus substance. So they are released from the phosphorus substance by weathering process. Weathering process. What is the weathering process? That is a natural process. End of this, they are released in the phosphorus. So after that, they are circulating with the lithosphere as well as hydrosphere. So what is in the lithosphere? During the weathering process, they are released in the phosphorus. After that, they are circulating with the lithosphere. And hydrosphere. So what is in the lithosphere? The surface of soil is called lithosphere, whereas hydrosphere is the total amount of water surface including ocean or aquatic region. That's why the hydrosphere. So already we learned that the food chains producer. So the producer absorbed phosphorus for the phosphate ions. So after that, the ion transfer into each tropical level. Tropical level of food chain. So already we learned that the permits, just to recall this, tropical level 1, tropical level 2, tropical level 3, tropical level 4. Tropical level 1 is producer. The producers the absorbed phosphorus from the phosphorus ions from the soil. So after that are transferred into the tropical level, herbivorous, sorry. Herbivorous, carnivorous, and top carnivorous. So therefore, the ions move from producer into the carnivorous, sorry, herbivorous into the carnivorous into the top carnivorous. So finally, this organism, again, death of this organism and deposit by the actions of decomposer. So what is in the decomposer? The decomposer is nothing but microorganisms like bacteria, fungi, some other microbes. That's why the decomposer. So after they are released in the phosphorus. Thus phosphorus back into the lithosphere and hydrospheres. So again, end of decomposer process, they released phosphorus. Thus phosphorus re back into the lithosphere or hydrosphere. Lithosphere, somebody will learn that surface of the soil, hydrosphere total amount of the waters. So finally, these are maintained with phosphate cycle. Okay, student. Today class is over. Thank you.